Hey everyone, welcome you all. In the today's video, I'm going to show you how we can find a specific element on the web page. So for example, I've taken this web page, books by kilo.in. In this, there are so many books are available in this particular page. And when I scroll down the page like this, you can see so many books which are available in this page. So I want to find out a particular book or a specific book is available in this list or not. So the tricky thing is, you can't find all the books in one page itself. So you need to scroll down the page like this so that you can find number of books which are available in the web page. So let us take a book which is somewhere in the middle of the page or bottom of the page, and then we will find whether the book is available or not. Okay, so let's go back to the Eclipse and create a new class which is already created a new project, new Maven Java project in my package. I'm going to create a new class. I'll name it as a find a book in a scrolling page, okay, which is basically a scrolling page because we cannot see all the books at the one shot. So we have to scroll down the page to see all the books. So let us see what are the solutions are there and whether it will work or not. And then we will find out the right solution. So I created WebDriver instance here and then maximizing the page. And after that, I'm trying to launch my page. I say driver dot get, and here I'm trying to pass the URL of the application and then try to maximize the page. Say driver dot manage dot window dot maximize. So I'm trying to maximize the page. Okay, so let us try to apply the first solution. So normally if you want to find any web element which is present on the web page, what you will do is we will try to capture that element and we will see whether it is present or not. Okay, because we have a scrolling option here, we will try to scroll the page, right? And then we will see whether book is present or not. And there are multiple ways are there, guys. So one, suppose, for example, if it is a scrolling page, what we can do is by using either JavaScript executor or by using action class method, we can scroll down the page till we find the particular element. Okay, for example, let's say I'm looking for some element. I'm looking for some book which is present in this page. So I can scroll down till I found that particular book. Okay. So for example, I'm scrolling down here and I try to capture some book here. Like I said, the Ville Victorians, right? So I'm just capture that book. So let's copy this title. So let's capture all the titles. So actually this is the book I want to look for. So for that, what I'll do is I will try to write a statement here. I say driver dot find element. Let us try to write an XPath for this particular element. Let's inspect this element and capture XPath or CSS for that particular element. So this is the element. This is a book I'm looking for. So capture that element. I say by.XPath. And okay, so this is the element basically. I'm not getting the text. I'm considering this as an element. So this is book, which is actually a web element. Right. So now we need to scroll down the page till I found this particular book element. Okay. So normally what we can do, we have an actions class actually. So there are multiple methods are there. Let me show you. So first let us create an actions class. Actions act equal to new actions. We need to pass a driver inside this. And now I'm just using one method. Scroll wheel methods are available in the actions class. So one of the method is act dot scroll to element. Okay, scroll to element. Even through JavaScript executor also we can achieve this, but there is a built-in method available in the actions class. So I already captured the element here. Now I want to scroll down the page till I found this element. So action class object act dot scroll to element. Now I'm passing this element, then perform the action. Okay, now let us see whether it is scrolling till we reach that element or not. Okay, this is a one solution I'm applying using actions class method, scroll to element. Now when I execute it, just you observe this, I'm launching the page. See, it is not scrolled actually. Okay, but that element is somewhere in the middle of the page or somewhere in the bottom of the page. So to get the element, we need to scroll it because once you scroll, you can find a lot of elements. So this solution won't work. You can see the error, no such element exception, because it could not find the particular element on the web page, because that element is present somewhere in the page. Once you scroll down, then only you will get it. But this is not work. Scrolled element is not work. Suppose if the page is static and all the elements are available on the web page, present on the web page at one shot, then this method will work. Scrolled element, go to the method, go to the element, and then perform the action. Okay, now this solution didn't work using actions class method. Now let us try to apply another solution. So this is actions class method. This is got failed using actions class method. So now let us try some other option using JavaScript executor, whether we are able to scroll till that element find or not. So let me take this same element once again. Now, instead of using actions class method, I'm trying to use JavaScript executor method. I will scroll down the page till I found this element. So for that, we need to create a JavaScript executor object. So we already created an actions class object here. So now I'll create a JavaScript executor object. So here I will create at the beginning. So import this JavaScript executor. And now by using JS, I will try to execute a script using execute script. So how we can scroll page till we found the element, we need to pass two parameters. One is element we have to pass, a second parameter. Now the first parameter is what? Arguments of zero. Arguments of zero means the element whichever we pass here, that will be considered in this. And then we need to scroll till that element found. So we need to use one method called scroll into view. So this is a particular thing which will basically scroll down the page till this element is visible on the page. Same thing, whatever that action class method is doing, same JavaScript executor method is also doing the same thing. But let us see whether this will solve the issue or not. So whatever book I'm expecting, so that book should be visible on the page till that scroll page should be scrolled. Now when I execute it again, just notice here, I think we could not find the book still here. So instead it is simply saying again, no such element exception. So because it is a scrolling page, we were not able to find an exact item which is present on the page, even though if I use scroll to element or scroll into view options from the JavaScript executor. So this is also a failed solution with a JavaScript executor. Now, what is the right solution? So how we can achieve this? So we need to write a logic for that. Okay, we need to implement a logic. So what is the logic we need to implement? So we need to repeat the loop, or we need to scroll the page multiple times till that book is visible on the web page. So we need to scroll like this till the book is visible on the web page. So how we can do that? Let me implement the logic for that. So here I'm taking one a variable, temporary variable found equal to false initially, and I'm taking this as a boolean variable just to maintain the status whether it is found or not. So I'm starting with the false, means it is not found. Okay, so I'm starting a loop statement here, while loop, and if not found, I'm taking found is a negative value here. Okay, found false, so not found is become what? True. If it is a true, it will enter into the while loop. So inside the while loop, I will capture all the books which are available in the current page. So without scrolling, suppose initially the page is here. So I will capture all the current books which are available in this. Then I will capture each and every book one by one and compare with my book title. And if it is a matching, then it is found. Or I will scroll end of the page once again like this. Again, capture all the books, again, do the comparison. And if it's not matching, then again, scroll the till end of the page, again, capture all the books, again, compare it. So this we will repeat multiple times till we found the exact book. So inside the while loop, I have to capture all the books. So for that, I'm writing one XPath. Let me inspect and go to selector hub. And here, this is... Let's go to the parent element of all the books. And this is a parent element. And inside this, I'm using H4 tag, zero element H3. So that is matching with all the titles of the book. Currently, it is showing 100 elements. So let me just capture this because we are there in some middle of the page. Okay, this will capture all the titles of the books. So here inside the loop, I'm just using driver.findElements because I want to capture titles of all the books. So here I'm using XPath and I'm capturing all the books into this variable. So this is a list of web element. Right, so now import this list. All right, so once we capture all the books, now we need to read the title of each and every book, and that is exactly equal to our expected title or not. That we need to verify. So for that, internally, I'm writing one more for each loop because we want to compare with each book title. From the books, I'm capturing each book one by one. This is a web element. Right, so from this book, I'm extracting the title. So extracting the text, not the title. So text I'm extracting, that I want to compare with our expected book title. I say book.getText dot equals, and what's our book title? So this is our book title. So let me take this and keep it in the double quotes. Okay, now if it is matching, then what we should say? Immediately, we can simply say book found. Okay, we can simply say book found. And we need to also make this flag is true. Okay, because we found the book, we make it as a true. So that what will happen next time, this loop will not be repeated. And after that, we need to break the loop. Immediately, we have to break the loop. So once this loop, internal loop is tested in every round of iteration, like every round of a page scroll, this loop will be executed. Okay, for example, once you read all the books and capturing the title and comparing with, none of them are not matched. So after completion of the for loop, then what we should do? We should scroll down the page. We should scroll down the page. So to scroll down the page, what we can do, we need to use either JavaScript executor method or we can use a keyboard action method. So let me use to scroll down the page. I will try to use js.executeScript. We need to scroll down till end of the page. So for that, we need to pass one parameter, window.scrollby. From 0 to end of the document, we need to scroll. So 0 to document.body.scrollHeight and close it. And no, there are no second parameter is needed. So this will scroll down the page. Okay, js.executeScript window.scrollby 0 document.body.scrollHeight and close the bracket. And here one more quotation and close the bracket. Okay, that's it. So this is simple logic which we need to do, guys. So let me repeat once again. Initially, we are starting with false, found equal to false. So not found means if it is not found, then we are capturing the books. Read each and every book, capture the title and compare with this. Okay, I think we need to put one more bracket. Okay, compare with this title. If it is matching, then book found, make the found flag is true and break the loop. Okay, if it is not found, then again capture another book and compare with each and every book. Suppose if not matching with any of the books, then we need to scroll down the page. Then you will get another some more books. Again, capture all the books. Again, do the same process. Okay. So after completion of this, let us exit from the page, driver.quit. Done. So let's execute this. I'm using JavaScript executor method here. Fine. So let's go and execute. So now you can see it is scrolled down the page. Now I found some book somewhere here. Perfect. Now, is there any other solution we have along with the JavaScript executor? So we have a method in actions class also. Through keyboard actions, we can scroll down the page. So instead of using JavaScript executor, whichever I already created actions class object, I can take act dot. We can use sendKeys method. Inside the sendKeys method, I can use end. So this will basically click on end key from your keyboard. It will go to the end of the page. Then perform the action. Simply dot perform. So this will do the scrolling. Same thing, whatever JavaScript executor is doing here, same thing is done by the keyboard action from the actions class. So action class is also provided at methods through which we can do the keyboard actions. And here I will also put some wait time so that it will be loaded one by one. I can make 2 seconds. Okay, so let's go and see whether the book is found or not. So through keyboard action, I have done it. Now it is scrolling down. Yeah, now we can see book is got found. So this is how we need to handle the scrolling pages especially. So directly, we can't capture the element. We cannot find the element. Okay, and we need to scroll the page parallelly. So then only we will be able to achieve this. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.